We're back. It's been a while, I know. We're back with Life is Strange. I think last time we left off was episode 1, unfortunately. But we're back. Episode 2. Last time, the first 3 episodes had none of my audio that you're hearing now, hopefully hearing now. So to avoid that problem of awkwardness of 3 more episodes being no audio, we're going to do this one full, one whole episode of this, and then we'll see. If there's audio, then we'll just keep doing it this way. Because apparently the other way is not allowed. Okay, so I'm assuming if I hit continue right now, I'll play episode 2, because I can't exactly remember if I finished 1 or not, but I guess we'll find out. If you'd like a timestamp of when this is recorded, this was recorded, literally I just played episode 2 of Clementine's The Walking Dead Season 3 New Frontier. I don't know why I said Clementine's. It's not even in the title. And if you haven't guessed, I really like story-driven games like this. Well, this will help me remember what the hell happened.
What the fuck?
I don't like the opaque over the subtitles. I was hoping it'd just be a little blur.
Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
This is horrible. What the hell is this?
Do you understand what I'm saying?
You're an asshole still.
Leave me alone.
Fucking abusive pedophile.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone. Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max? Tell me everything.
What's pretty cool is whether or not this place is real, but this is based in some place in Oregon. Can't remember where. But, yeah, that's literally 3 hours from here, which is pretty cool. Yeah, I'll hit that snooze that I can't fucking see. It's so much different than the cartoonish style. Some busting jams. God, I sound like I'm 50. That's a pretty cool screensaver. Sorry, is she in college or just like... I think she's in college the way she speaks, but it sounds like she's also in high school. Speaks. The classes she's taking about photography, and that seems to be her only focus. So, episode 2 out of time. Hopefully we don't run out of that. Hey. God, put some clothes on. Who sleeps without a blanket? Oh. Fuck me, right? Jesus.
I am so wrecked after staying up all night. I could use my rewind to catch a few more Z's, but maybe I better save my strength. Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower. I am so not a rebel. I always like my bed to be neat and tidy. Thanks, Mom.
What the fuck was that all about? Oh, journal. Okay. Bill, are you there? No emoji. either. Why is it so fast? What was that clicking sound? Well, no time is not. Don't be. Don't get high like in my room. 4 minutes or else. Jesus. Oh, that's right. Pictures. Is this of me traveling? What's with the star? Details. Oh, yeah. Because these are all the pictures I guess I could have taken, but God. The gun. Now, these pictures I could take throughout the entire game, I'm assuming, because a lot of this thing I had never seen. Okay. So details on people, right. God, that was just a Monday? Fuck Mondays, man. Alright, Mom. Happy birthday, Max. We can't believe it's been 18 years since you were brought to us. Well, okay, so she's 18. No, just kidding. Fucking God. Max, your principal sent me an email saying that you told some tall tales about a black. Is that true? The principal said there was a... Well, it turns out he's worried you're telling stories. Call me, except so we can talk about this, Mom. Hey, honey, I hope you didn't forget to water the plant we gave you, but don't drown it either. God, Mom.
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. It would be fun to get some peeps together and play a real game instead of drama games.
Yeah, let's turn off the music for now. Photos, sticky notes. No, yeah, fine, fucking take a selfie. I don't give a damn.
No smiling. Take your power seriously. Drink up. It's got electrolytes. Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now. Good morning, Chloe. I hope you slept well. Now... Uh-oh. I wonder if I'll ever wear a watch again.
Gordon, seriously? Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like, now. Thanks, Sherry. Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, consider it done. Ow!
Can I block it at all? Nope, ow! Apparently not. Well then, do I just pick one?
Hey, Max.
Hey, Kate. How are you doing?
I'm here. Thanks again for standing up for me yesterday. I needed that.
Anytime. That guy has issues.
Doesn't everybody here? By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
The shower stopped. Alright, whatever. What's so important about this moment? I feel like something bad's gonna happen.
What's up, Kate?
School. That's it? That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Victoria, that
she's getting blackmailed?
Me. Oh my god, right.
Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way-
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate. Or Max.
Backstabbing bitch. No. Never fucking liked her in the first place.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway, let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
You are such an evil biatch. I love it.
Yeah, I'm gonna wipe that away. Yeah, I can't rewind, apparently. Come on, come on, come on, come on. I gotta wipe that away before anybody sees it.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book. Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Hell yeah. Fucking that's embarrassing. Alright, well, let's get Kate's book back. Yeah. Well, I have no idea who Rachel is. Oh, thank god. I thought she's gonna be right outside here and be like, what are you doing? Yeah. Do I really have to do all this miscellaneous work? Where'd that come from? Okay.
No fucking way. This is not why I came to Blackwell. And I still have to clean all this crap up after I find Kate's book.
Photos. Look at photos.
Man, this could almost be art if it wasn't so fucking sick and disturbed.
Alrighty then.
Oh shit. Nathan's revenge. Even Chloe told me not to go to the principal.
Oh shit.
And nothing here.
Damn, would it be up in the bookshelf, maybe? Okay, it's not letting me interact with it.
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there. My desk is a pig's.
Oh, okay. What's that in the papers? Search here. Hey, you gotta be kidding.
She just spilled soda on Kate's book.
What do you
fix this fast?
What are you doing?
Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to our list of problems.
So, go back in time with that dear rewind powers. Move the cup.
Be gone, foul soft drink.
What was that? That.
Aha,
oh, God.
You're mine.
Yeah, so sneaky. Get the book back to this girl.
I need to get dressed before I go there.
Get dressed then.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans. Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time.
Or could he? I don't know. God, I'm so paranoid about doors now.
Now I can finally take this back to Kate before I'm late.
Victoria.
As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now.
Max's room. Oh, Kate's room. Okay.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
Hey, Kate. I brought your book.
Max, why did you step in between David and me yesterday?
I hate bullies. David Madsen should know better.
I was hoping he would. But it's nice to see that you care about me.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass. He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club. Yeah, right.
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video. You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
That's awful. So, how did that happen?
It's a long story. I'm still trying to sort it all out.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember getting sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Did you go?
Definitely not. I'm not sure where I went.
What do you remember about that?
All I recall is driving for a long time. And I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck. And? That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
Oh,
so,
God.
Who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here, near my bag.
Damn. That's fucked up. Fucking sounds like she got fucking raped and drugged. Oh, damn.
So, Max? Can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
I want to say yes because he's such a prick.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, no, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt.
There's a bit of...
So that's your answer?
Why?
I think you should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Oh, shit, it's not
her
fault.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
No emoji. Oh, oh. Private number, huh? Great, we got a stalker.
Oh, shit. Now I'm getting anonymous threats? It never ends. This has to be from Nathan. But it could be anybody. I better be doubly careful around here or I could...
Hey, Brooke. Oh, hi, Max.
Did you see the freak snowfall yesterday?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
I will later.
Lucky you. I'm sure he'll track you down, Max. I'll see you around.
Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh, hello, young Max. I do love the early morning.
God, you talk so
weird. So calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
I hate that you talk in third person.
I'll talk to you later. I get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
You creep me the hell out. Beyond comfortable. Where should I go? I guess this way. Let's talk to minion number one.
Hi, Taylor.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Kill yourself, cunt. Jesus.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo.
Hello.
That's what happens when you preach to everybody
Christina
about sex.
Linksy?
She'll live.
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
Really? Yeah, let's go with bossy
I guess
best friends.
Mean bossy best friends too. Better than having mean bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Well then. Yeah, I'm not gonna rewind on that. What's there to What's there to rewind on that? She's... what? Private number. This is Nathan's father. This is a message just to let you know that attempts to slander and blackmail my son will be met with any lawmakers and legal ramifications. You're not the first student blackmail to try this. I hope you're the last. So I'm getting fucking, two private numbers. Great. Yep. Douche 1 and Douche 2 is what I should name those, but I don't think I can have that.
Max, come on over here.
Hey, Warren.
Warren, what are you doing here?
Sup, dude?
Nothing. Waiting for a call.
God, you look like shit.
I took the call. Anyway, I wanted to rap about that action yesterday.
That was intense. Everything happened so fast. I owe you.
Oh, yes, you do. I got knocked on my ass by that dick. I'm some personal superhero.
You're a real everyday hero. You stood up to a bully, and it was awesome.
Even though you left me with said bully and ran off with that girl, she's pretty punk rock. How do you know her?
An old friend, Chloe Price. We haven't seen each other in a while.
I bet you were glad to see her blast up in that truck like a rock star.
Hell
Which
yeah.
begs the question, why is Nathan Prescott getting psycho on you?
He's dangerous. I don't want you to get involved. You got me there, but lay low. Nathan Prescott is going to get his karma soon.
Weird fucking week. Like that bizarro snowfall yesterday? Speaking of dystopia, that drive-in is having a 70s Planet of the Apes marathon. Let's go, ape!
Yeah, let's go!
That's exactly what I need. I love those old-school ape films.
Well, that was easier than I thought. Cool, I'll text you the info.
David talking to Nathan cannot be a good thing. This has something to do with Kate. Or Rachel.
I thought that guy was a bus driver. I was like, bus driver's pretty hip hairstyle. Oh, this music's pretty good. Cutscene I've ever seen for a goddamn bus ride. Like, why do I need to see all this? It's what my town looks like pretty much, except for without the ocean part. The two whales or whatever. What? Does the school bus think I just live there?
Don't try to take it from me. It's mine.
I wouldn't dream of it.
I'm gonna be a millionaire. Hope nobody steals my lottery.
Talk about going back in time. The diner looks exactly the same.
Come on, get in there.
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware.
Where is she at?
Makes
Chloe.
Me
oh, hell no. Oh, she's running late. I'll be lucky if you make it by now.
13.
Yeah. Get best. What is this?
Coming up at noon, KBay 7 News will explore the mystery of yesterday's unusual snowfall on a warm and sunny late afternoon that confused and delighted Arcadia Bay residents. We'll be talking with Portland Media.
Why did the voice change?
Look at some of your fun video reactions to the odd snowfall. Maybe Mother Nature was pranking us all. So stay tuned to KBay 7 News for the real story.
Dude. Cop. You can. Trucker. Jesus. Do I get to just pick one or do I have to get the one over? Yep.
She is a lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man, no matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. It was very stupid. I'm sorry.
Oh, it surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle, and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did, after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories, even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's gotta rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
David scared me when he said he might have my scholarship taken away for that stupid joint.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
I get it, Joyce. I know Chloe still likes to stir things up.
Yeah, she does provoke people, especially David. I just want us to be a family soon. I guess it's all about time.
I think you're right, Joyce.
So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
Called a Belgian waffle.
The last good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry girl, pronto.
One Belgian waffle at 12 o'clock high.
Nerd, I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast. This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is a diner, not a bar.
No beer?
Looks like you had plenty. Stick with bacon.
The lighthouse looks so mysterious. I wish I could stay in this moment forever. I guess I actually can now. But then it wouldn't be a moment.
What kind of dive is this?
Wait.
Incoming.
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, ugh. Speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl. Woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox? Now that that's out of the way. Let's talk about your superpower.
I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A skull keychain for a punk like you.
That was so...
Fuck!
Wrong, Max. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond
bear.
Epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Bear cigarettes change in a note?
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
Bullet?
Just like your necklace.
That was so wrong, Max. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my
pocket.
Wait, pockets.
What? Well, it's not a razor blade either.
That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Oh, come. Oh, okay, thank God.
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max, I'm hella ready.
Keys?
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
You definitely have a razor blade keychain.
That was so wrong. Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's at.
See, okay, so I guess not the keys, tube of glitter, sticky gum.
That was beyond epic fail.
Am I supposed to fail no matter what? One more time, and I'm gonna try tube of glitter, for fuck's sake.
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
What the hell was that?
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Super glitter.
You have a tube of glitter in there, right?
Nada. Wrong answer. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's action.
Okay. Oh, maybe I should look first.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
My god. Keys with a panda. Cigarettes. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 75, 80, 86 cents. And this is a warning ticket. Here we go. Okay then.
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Ooh! Keys!
Your car keys.
Duh, I'm gonna get the keys this time.
I need details. Describe my keychain.
Panda keychain. Boom,
cute
son.
Robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Cigarettes.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
Oh, you... 13.
13 cigarettes.
I smoke too much to have 13 cigarettes. Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually
oh,
in my
no.
pockets.
Ah, I have to remember the fucking cigarette number 2. My god,
that
don't tell me
that was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe.
All right, let's
okay,
look
Max,
again.
Study every item carefully.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6,
anything.
Fucking 7. Okay, well, 86 cents and read this out of parking bay. Okay, here you go. Quickly go back in time again. God, there has to be some horrible backlash from this.
This is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max.
You somehow imbued the powers of the stone
keys.
Of time.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Cigarettes
I'm
with
pretty sure
seven.
You have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Money.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
Aha. Oh, I was gonna say 86
cents.
That's right, living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
A parking ticket.
There
you know
we
me
go.
Well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
Oh, kill yourself. 10:34.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell
us. Oh, thank God.
Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. And now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Snap. You're not gonna go chase it. Okay. No, I guess not yet. Well, how far back do I go?
This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
Okay, so...
Trevor drops his glass and Justin makes fun of him.
So, what happens next?
The cop
emergency alert on his radio and exits the diner.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
The jukebox
goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
Oh, God.
Oops.
That is so
wrong. Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Actually, I just gotta let it play through because I don't remember seeing what hit the... Oh, what is that?
Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
Is that right about
the... Don't slap
me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
Oh, yeah, I was right about
this. This is sure the hell better than that other garbage.
Cockroach.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Oh, God damn it. So, I did fail that. Alright, fast. But it was a cockroach, so I'm glad I got that right.
I'm going to predict.
Boom. Let's see. Trucker drops his mug.
The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good! Can't wait to see what happens!
The jukebox goes crazy.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see.
Oops.
Did you break another cup?
Oh, way
really?
To go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called it. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This isn't a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
Okay, Supergirl. Let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and what to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit, let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with too.
Hey, Kate. What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now. Let's rock.
Jeez.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument.
And who the hell are you? Fucking put a barcode on his neck. Fucking call him Agent 47. This place.
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
How are you gonna have any fun?
David might be a douche, but you did steal his gun. Is everybody armed in Arcadia Bay now?
Only the ones who shouldn't be, like Step Dildo. Until now.
I'm not in the revolution yet, Che.
You are the revolution, Max. So we should figure out how to best use and abuse your power with a test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Yeah, I guess. Fuck, would 5 bottles be? Oh, there's one. Really? Take.
Stupid bottle.
Oh, for fuck's sake, use your hands!
So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now.
Ooh, old camera.
Beyond repair. Rest in peace.
Oh.
I wonder how many generations. Whoa.
Back out of that. What is that sound? That sounded like a plane crashing. Okay then. Ooh, bottles. Or one.
Hello, bottle number one. 4 more to go. I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars. Wowzer. That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision.
No way. Where are you going, bud?
The dough is the perfect photo op.
So concerned. I feel like something's about to happen. Can I go up this way? Am I supposed to see the deer anymore? Well, okay then. I guess we'll just fucking forget about it. Oh, hello. Stump. Sit on stump? Oh.
It's so quiet and primordial out here. I always feel like the forest is whispering to me. Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something.
What do the trees sound like? Metal pipes. No idea what to do. Okay, I guess I'll get back up. Gotta find some more. Ooh, I think that's a bottle right there. I'll come back to it though. No bottles over here. Oh, wait. Look.
This was an old school punk shirt.
Is it just called piece of cloth? Oh, okay, yeah. Well, clothing. Whatever.
This is the scariest thing here. Oh, poor thing. They left you here all alone. This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here. That kind of hurts. Rachel songs. I wonder if Chloe would ever make me a mixtape. They really were besties. That could have been me instead of Rachel. Boom, only 3 bottles left. Ouch.
Can we have a time to crush about the TARDIS getting... Nice, going on a date. Hell yeah. Warren seems like a cool dude.
So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared. They would have gone all the way to Los Angeles for a rave. Looks fun.
Oh yeah, Portland, Oregon is one of the other rave areas, other than Seattle, isn't it? Near here, anyway. How open is this area to find 5 goddamn bottles?
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Don't want to go where? I didn't really see what there was.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Go right over here. Such an odd placement for tracks. Oh. Okay then.
Hmm.
Oh, hello. Wait, oh, I have to get up on there?
I bet I could get on the boat from a higher location.
No! Where would the higher location be? Okay, I have no clue what to do here. Oh, hello.
I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy.
So then fucking what do I do? Oh, great.
Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground. Those shells look fresh.
Okay.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh. Three down, two more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack. Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. We're hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time.
The fuck was that? Don't make that sound.
The Bigfoots were here.
What other area have I not looked at? Oh, back here, I guess.
It's hard to believe that was once on the road, filled with dozens of students.
Yeah, once.
No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay junk. Nope, I don't want to go there.
Well, no shit. Well, Chloe, I guess you're happy with three, because I don't know where the fuck the rest are.
I have to find dirty-ass bottles while you chill. Not fair.
I have to prep the range, crybaby. And I've been tripping hard about where you got this rewind power.
From God or the gods. So, bow.
We can make the world bow. Are you ready for that?
Oh, yes. Once I figure out exactly how my power works. A god must doth know these things.
Amen. And while you build an empire, I'm there to keep you on the path of badassness. And fun.
Spin, rinse, and repeat. I'm just altering time and space. Oh yeah, and history. No biggie.
You already altered history by saving my life, smartass. Let's see what else you can do.
Where to find bottles? Maybe in an old refrigerator.
Don't tell me I lose my bottles if I go back. Fix this fuck up. Let me guess, there's a way to fucking save that bottle. Yep, chilling by the tree, chilling by the tree. What? Oh, snap. Boom.
One more bottle to go.
Oh, fucking kill me now. God, I feel really bad for that girl.
Beyond repair.
Yeah. Oh, come on.
I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine.
Where would I find the last water bottle? Or water bottle? Because I found one over here, didn't I? Yeah, it doesn't replace the ones I actually found. So where is the fifth water? I don't know why I keep saying water. Maybe Chloe will just give up hers. I'll just go try that. Be like, yo, give up your fucking shit.
I have to find dirty ass bottles. I have to prep from... We can make... Amen. Spin, rent. You already altered history by...
Oh, great. I don't know where the last one is.
I know there's a bonfire spot where people party around here.
Alright, so how do I get in there? I could have walked back. Oh my god. Just kill me now. What? Oh, this game is so nice.
Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Oh, hello. Fucking shocker. Fucking shock me there.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road. You're serious about this? We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim. Show me the way, Max. I need to see you shoot first. Aim a bit to the right. Sir, yes, sir. Did you see that shit, Max? Duh. That was so fucking cool. Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim? You're on target. Pull the trigger.
A little bit up.
Aim slightly above. Right between the eyes.
Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here.
Give me something to shoot, Max.
Aim at that old blue plank here.
I hate old planks. Yawn.
Give me something to shoot, Max.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now?
Hella yes!
Nice shooting, Tex.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like, never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Put a real dent in that front bumper.
Goodbye, cruel bumper. Jesus, I shot myself!
No, I shot myself!
Back up!
Stupid gun! Hold on, Chloe.
Well, Max?
How about aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death. Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero! Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
I don't know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
No, not again. God, it almost gave me fucking epilepsy or whatever.
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. Glad I feel normal again. I better go chat up Chloe.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble? Oh, boo-hoo. Max is afraid. I know you can handle this. And I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
Oh, God, why? Yeah. Don't shoot.
Come on, girlie. Shoot me.
Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello. Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My stepshit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least he won't fuck with us again. It's his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me. Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a timeout from here.
Wowzer. Why did Frank have... I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
I'm still freaked out about what happened. That was awful, Chloe.
I'm sorry. But Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer, where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Hung out? You don't mean you...
Ah, no, we didn't have sex. Gross, man. He never even tried. I just made the mistake of borrowing money so Rachel and I could bail out of here.
That's it?
No. I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She had... has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
Isn't that an act of railroad anyway?
You just have to stop being afraid.
Perfect.
Oh!
Shit.
Take the shoe off.
I don't want to die here. I can't even move it an inch. Hurry! Awesome, it's not locked.
Look.
I better find a tool to cut those wires. Shit, I can't budge it at all. I can definitely use this bad boy. The train's coming! Max, please!
Yes, Chloe, I fucking know. Shut up. Come on, come on, come on. Open. Take.
Now I can pull a total, my guy.
No, God, I think she just got hit.
In and out, no problem.
Oh, the door actually closed behind me. That's kind of weird. Green wire.
Please get me out of here. Oh, stupid light. No go. Shit.
So don't cut the green wire. Definitely not the green wire.
But which wire to cut?
Yellow.
Whoa. Short circuit city.
That's what I needed, right? Okay, not that one.
But which wire to cut?
Red wire.
Now that's the right cable. Max! Yes, I did it. You okay?
You saved me again. Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life.
Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Aww.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar!
Like he said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week, and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again.
little time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
So are you going to that vortex?
These elite assholes throw a lot of big parties. Another chance for Nathan Prescott to dose somebody. Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
No, it belonged to a friend of mine. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
You stepped between us at a pretty bad time. She's another matter entirely.
Kate hasn't done anything wrong.
Max, this isn't just about Kate Marsh. My concern is for the safety of all Blackwell students, including you.
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max.
If my tornado vision came true, it would be the end of the world.
Well, just for Arcadia.
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
I have to score some weed from Nathan.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
Let's go with sodium.
I have a vision. Godium.
Godium? That's the worst pun I've ever heard. Yet Max has spoken. Sodium it is.
Please don't blow up. Please don't blow up. Please don't blow up.
Damn. Zip. Nothing. Nada.
Go faster. God.
Big brain.
Hey, Warren. Are you okay?
Maxwell.
Asking me.
Have that either.
Potassium.
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but go. Potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug.
Oof.
Weird science. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck. This can't be that hard.
Can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Why? You don't understand mine. What do you want from me?
Can I talk to you? No? Oh, okay. Bye, I guess.
Excuse me, Max. Can you come over here?
Sure.
You look worried. Is everything okay?
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
That's no secret. Word on the street is that you and Kate had a little confrontation with our security chief yesterday.
I stepped in between David Madsen barking all up in Kate's face about something. She doesn't deserve that.
Of course not. Mr. Madsen isn't the most gentle soul. Do you have proof he instigated the situation?
My word isn't good enough? The one time I choose not to take a picture.
Always take the shot. My number one rule of photography. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well,
I mean, what the hell?
She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
I miss Rachel too. But think about yourself, Max. Principal Wells told me about what you said happened in the bathroom.
It did happen. Nathan Prescott had a gun in the girls' bathroom yesterday.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon. Sure, okay. Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'll do that. Oh, I know. That makes sense. Huh? Mm-mm. Seriously, I have to hang up now. Let's talk.
Make me beautiful, Hayden. Vogue. Vogue. Vogue.
Dana.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress.
Then right. Show me the love.
Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
You look like ass.
Better be quiet, Victoria. We have a master snitch and liar here.
Did you think we were best friends forever or something?
Not at all, Victoria.
Max is such an attention whore.
You would know. Can I sit down now?
Oh, please do. Take a selfie of this moment.
Yeah, Max, so I won't forget you.
Assholes. Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit
Maybe
down.
I'll see
we
you
have
later.
A lot to cover today, and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
She's not feeling good.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video gone viral. Maybe it involves a student or a friend. I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. No smartphones in class, Max. Put that away. Usually, people need something to judge, so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating. Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example, who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mind.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
I am concerned, though, with what's going on. No. Please tell me. Please tell me no. No, don't tell me Kate jumped. No!
Kate!
No. No!
She can't die. She can't. Not again. Not now.
No!
I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
What's going on?
Keep going, Max. You can do it.
Holding time right now? Is that a thing I can do now? Or discovered?
Yes. Is it...
Any power. Now I have to do this by myself?
Max, seriously, don't come near me. I will jump.
Okay. I'm right here. Kate, please.
Oh, Max, I know you want to help me. I love that you stepped up to David, but it doesn't matter now. Nothing. And not just to yours. Without me, that makes me feel better.
I'll always be here for you, Kate. My new motto is friends come first.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay?
I can help you now. I know I can. This morning, I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now. Please, you don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm already on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Kate, this is our chance to beat the bullies. That's the only way we can win against them.
Can we really, Max? I don't believe in miracles anymore either.
Now I do. You're part of the reason why. If you come down with me, I can tell you more.
You're such a good person, Max. Even if you're full of crap. But I'll come with you. You're my friend.
Thank God.
Can we hug on it?
No. Nobody cares about me.
Wait, what?
Nobody.
What about your mother, Kate? You'll destroy her. She doesn't care about a video. She loves you.
You don't know my mother at all. She already thinks Satan has me on the fast track to hell. Let's prove it.
No. Kate, please stop. Listen. This isn't the end, Kate. There's no way God doesn't have big plans for you here.
Nice try, Max. But God put me on this roof.
Oh, God damn it. Suicide is a sin.
How does that proverb go? When justice is done, it brings joy to the righteous, but terror to the evildoers.
I don't believe in justice, Max. I don't believe in anything anymore.
No, get off the... No! God damn it, no! Oh, hey, Matt, if that's what you're trying to say. God fucking damn it. Was there any way to save her? I guess we'll never fucking know. Great.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us, but we have to go over what happened before Miss Marsh, before she did what she did. Officer Barry will be taking notes for the official police inquiry. I'm sure you'll give him your full cooperation. Such a tragedy.
Fuck you, Nathan.
But there must
Fuck
be a
you.
Reason for everything.
Oh, if I could reach through that screen and fucking kill you right now,
Kate
I would.
Marsh would be driven to such desperate action. As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duties seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility. Mr. Jefferson, I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, Tell us everything.
Fuck.
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and
playing
the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit. Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girl's bathroom?
That's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast. I already have a personal lawyer.
Careful, Mr. Prescott. I have been told of this alleged gun incident, and I have to admit that the video in question was sent to me by multiple sources.
Including me.
And since Mr. Prescott does appear prominently in the video and was responsible for the party, I have no choice but to suspend him until further notice.
Whatever. See you in court.
Fuck you, dude.
I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and fellow student is dead. And they don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now. I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
What would I... You know what? No. Fuck him. Straight up, sign statement. Yep. Then take the pen and jab him in the throat. Just fucking jab him.
Well, I think we know less now than when we started. We'll be assisting the police with further inquiries. I know this has been a stressful day. I wish I had the power to change it all for the better. So thank you for coming in.
I just can't believe it. It's like it wasn't even real. Watching her drop like a weight. I really thought I could save her. Like a superhero.
Come on, Max. Do not for a second blame yourself. Kate was on that roof for her reasons, not yours.
My hand just reached out.
Stop it. You were the only one with balls enough to run to the roof. You were the only one who cared.
Yeah, I sure made a big fucking difference. Maybe if more people cared, better people than me.
You're the best person around.
Warren, I screwed up today.
That makes no logical sense.
Warren, I don't mean to sound weird, but there's something ominous going on at Blackwell.
Today proves that.
And I'm working on proof that Kate Marsh is connected to Rachel Amber. Somehow. Along with Nathan and Mr. Madsen.
I'm not a big conspiracy guy, but I wouldn't doubt it. Nathan did scare me yesterday, and Madsen is a straight-up dickhead. So, what do you think is really happening?
What the hell is this? The weather confirms this weird day. I feel that chill.
Max, there was no eclipse scheduled today. I would know. I would.
Yeah, I'd be fucking a little tweaked out too.
I believe anything this week.
I feel like Mr. Madsen was actually trying to help. I don't know why he was being creepy about it, but... Digging like you can't bear. One of his students just committed suicide. Give him a break. Yeah, all your fault, bitch. Fucking bitch. And you too, you little bastard. I am pissed. Ugh. If you're interested, Matt, I just did a video, and anybody else who's watching, of Walking Dead episode 2 for season 3, probably 2 hours ago. Should be on past podcasts. I really hope that there was no way of avoiding this, because if not, then I'm gonna be even more livid than I already am. But I feel like there's no way to get past it without her dying. Hey, Chavez Slice 5? Poor Kate. God, I could tell she was being bothered by something from like the first 5 fucking seconds. Yep, I guess that's the fucking end of the episode. Great. Well, I guess I'll do episode 3 tomorrow. Unless you're watching this on YouTube, which it'll probably be out next week or so. I don't know. I don't ever have a schedule at this point, just because I'm so busy with work. Thank you for watching. Can't see the gameplay. You should be able to. Anyway, thanks for watching. I'm gonna go to bed now. I'm tired. Worked a graveyard shift, got off at 6, and it's now 12 o'clock in the afternoon. And I gotta be back to work at 10. So, bye guys. Hope you enjoyed. God, both games I just played had a really shitty ending today. Why? Why is that? Why couldn't this one have a soft ending or happy? I guess it's the same thing. Anyway, I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye bye.